Welcome everyone to the Mod Squad Horror Show. Welcome everyone to the Mod Squad Movie Talk Monday. I'm your host Harley. Oh. As always, joined by the wonderful Felix.
So,
and we've got the fabulous Brandon.
Great.
Okay, let's start our show off with our sponsors. Guys, go check out Skullectomy by Jolt 7 Studios. Her skulls are awesome, one of a kind, and unique. We also have Scott Strzok Art. Guys, his art is awesome. He's got Christmas horror coming out. Scan those QR codes and let them know the Mod Squad sent you. We also have t-shirts and beanies. Guys, scan that QR code right here and order your t-shirt and beanie. Okay, let's start off with our first trailer.
For the last 3 years, Griselda Blanco has owned Miami, distributing cocaine.
Miss Blanco's operation has been efficient, deadly, and incredibly successful.
Damn.
Let's get to work.
There's a lot of women who leave the man, but not the life.
I swear. I know what I'm doing.
Did your parents ever send you to buy cigarettes with a note and money to the liquor store?
It wasn't acceptable in the 90s.
I want to cut her head off.
I was a kid in the 80s, so.
Vaya a casa, señora.
I'm going to tell everything.
The cigarettes just reminded me of that.
Not to touch your coke.
This is what
that calling for? You
pinch yourself a little more money, a little more juice. Then people get hurt. No! One woman is behind all this. Pull the right card. The whole house comes down.
Medina anda preguntando por vos. Dice que hay una mujer mafiosa en los Estados Unidos. La madrina.
After all that I have
been. This seems like your type of movie, Arlie.
Get away for nothing.
Quiere ver que tan puto lejos llego.
Y caído en una berraca.
Pero nunca ser como ella.
Se está protegiendo.
Esa mujer no caminaba como la novia de nadie.
Pues, ¿cómo caminaba?
Como la jefa.
Netflix.
It's like the lady Scarface.
I was just going to say, what is it going to be called? Pretty Face instead of Scarface?
I like roles in movies where they have the woman that are like empowering like that. And I love Sophia in every role that she is in because she is badass.
The only thing I'm going to say is hope we didn't see the ending in that because there was one shot that looked like it was the ending of the movie. So hopefully it wasn't.
Yeah, it looked pretty good though.
Yeah, it did.
From comicbook.com, Beetlejuice 2, William Dafoe reveals details about his character. Also from Bloody Disgusting, Tim Burton celebrates the end of filming on Beetlejuice 2 with set photos taken in familiar location. Guys, I have this photo for you, and it's a pretty awesome looking photo.
Waiting room.
Yep. I wonder if we're gonna see some of the same people still waiting in there all these years from Beetlejuice goes there.
I would think so. That's gotta be a running gag, right?
Yeah.
The dead DMV. Yeah, there's some of the same people still sitting there.
I'm so excited for this.
Willem Dafoe says his character was a B-movie film star. and he used to play like a detective and such. So now in the dead world, he's playing this a detective for them since he knew what he was doing back in that.
Yeah.
I just thought that was funny.
Fantastic. I can't wait for that. I have a hard time still believing that we're getting a Beetlejuice 2. Like, I feel like we've been getting fake movie posters and fake news about it for over a decade now. I agree. Now it's like already like wrapped filming. I'm sure there's tons of post stuff for them to do, but it just blows my mind that we're actually getting a Beetlejuice 2.
I remember when we first started Movie Talk Monday, and me and Raven Rose was talking about how there was rumors of Beetlejuice 2 coming out, and Felix was like, no, 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 it's not true. There's not going to be a Beetlejuice 2.
There have been rumors about this for years.
Which is why I was saying no.
It was never anything more than just fans hoping that it would that it would happen.
And now we have
it's hard to believe. It's hard to believe actual, and even still, I mean, there's still so much fake stuff that gets posted all the time. I see fake movie posters pop up all the time, and it drives me friggin' insane because so many people are gullible and fall for it. And it's like, no, stop. It's not real.
Especially all the fake ones where they've got like Jenna Ortega with the bride veil over her. And all that, because I've seen that one quite a few times.
I always pop in those articles and say this is a fan-made poster. Yeah. I've seen them enough that sometimes Harley, in the beginning, she doesn't do it so much anymore. She would send me something. I'm like, that's a fan-made poster. It's not real. I just, you know, you got an eye for it after all these years.
From Joe Blow, Timothy Olyphant to star in Noah Hawley's Alien TV series for Fox FX.
I love Timothy Olyphant. I cannot wait for
anything.
He's so freaking cool.
And that's another star where if they pick a role, you know it's going to the script is decent. And this has nothing to do with the other movie that we talked about in the horror show, which will come out this Wednesday. But I think they're both in the universe still of Aliens, but this is like its own set. And again, what they did with Prey and the Predator, I just love that movie. I hope keep that going over here with the Alien show, especially now that they're getting stars on it and such.
I like the idea of a series set in the Alien world. That's really cool. And like I say, he's a badass. I mean, he was great in Deadwood and Justified and Mandalorian. I mean, The Office.
Santa
Clarita Diet. I know. That's still a show that pisses me off.
I was so mad. Canceled.
I was so mad. I think everybody was. Everybody was a fan of that show. That's one of those shows. I just don't understand how it got canceled.
And they didn't end it very well either.
They ended it, to go on to the next.
It was a total cliffhanger. Yeah. Maybe in, 10 years, we'll get one of those revivals that they're so keen on right now, reviving shows.
That seems to be quite popular here lately. Let's revive a show that's 10 years old.
Yep. I mean, that had a funny twist to it that you don't really see out there done anymore. It was like it took a swing at something, and I think it hit a home run,
which
I don't know why they didn't finish running all the bases.
Yeah.
I mean, it had a lot of viewers in the first place. That show was hilarious. From Joe Blow, Bob Iger wants Disney to step away from messages in their films. This article made me a little upset.
Did it?
Well, we were talking about it in prep earlier about how it doesn't, we don't see that it's going to be benefit Disney in the process of removing all the messages. That's why parents, some of them have their kids watch these movies.
You know, I think that the issue, a lot of it really is Disney's always had messages in their movies, but they haven't felt so force-fed. And I feel like that's kind of a problem of it. That they've run into recently is it feels like they're forcing shit down your throat. And you don't need to do that if you have a good story, if you have good writers. You don't need to be so obvious with the message, So with that, I will say, I mean, yeah, the movies should have some sort of message, obviously, or there's no point in making them. But I do think they need to do a better job of making it natural and not alienating a lot of people and force feeding shit down people's throats, which they've been pretty good at doing recently, I think. But also, Bob Iger, this guy sucks. So I don't know.
Bob Chapek is the one that sucks. That's why it's been bad the past three years. Bob Chapek was in charge. He got fired. Bob Iger's back.
Too. Bob Iger sucks too. As a person, he's just a freaking asshole. But yeah, they all suck.
I thought you meant what they do.
They're all just money grubbing freaking, you know, rich folk that.
Anyway, agreed.
We'll see.
I just hope that it doesn't negatively affect Disney, because they've already lost a lot of money here lately with all their stuff that they're doing. I don't see it going positive for them.
I mean, that's what he's trying to do, though. That's why he's trying to wreck the boat right now, because yeah, Disney is drowning right now, and he's trying to do what he thinks needs to be done to right the boat, especially with like the Marvel movies, you know, talking about not putting out as many Marvel movies and focusing more on the story and quality over quantity and stuff like that. And that's all, you know, good to say. Yeah. It's easier said than done. Like, we need to actually see it now. Like, we need to actually be able to care about these movies again. Nobody gives a shit about these movies anymore.
Like I was always told growing up, put your money where your mouth is.
Yeah.
Okay, this next article, I'm actually excited for this one. From Bloody Disgusting, Godzilla X Kong. The new Empire Kong remains king and on tease poster for next MonsterVerse movies. I've got those posters for you guys. And they look really awesome.
When Brandon shared them in the chat, I thought they did an awesome job on them too. I thought they were clever the way they were done. Cool.
Yeah, super cool. Love that. Unite 2024. Yeah, he's bitching.
You know this is the villain. Yeah.
Clearly, yeah, the bad guy. So that's the, you know, antagonist there. Which, yeah, I know Kevin mentioned it. He does kind of look like an orangutan, kind of.
He does. So when Kevin said that, I was like, yeah. Like
another giant ape type character, which is pretty cool. Yeah, I'm excited. I love the MonsterVerse. So I haven't started watching the show on Apple TV yet.
We're two episodes in. It is so good, man. Watch it.
I've heard a lot of mixed reviews on it. I've heard a lot of people say that it's really boring, and I just don't have time for a boring show. But if you say it's good, I'll check it out.
We're waiting till all the episodes are on there to watch it. Yeah. But I have heard a lot of positive things about Godzilla. The new one, minus one or plus one.
Well, that was a lot of, but it's not in this universe, though.
Yeah, it's not part of the MonsterVerse. That's a standalone, you know, like the Japanese production of Godzilla. And apparently that one is supposed to be amazing. I've been hearing really good reviews about that one. I really want to see it in theater. But that's supposed to be the start of like a new
that's what I'm hearing too.
For the Japanese production, which is really cool. And I love the design of him. He's kind of like a mashup between old, you know, OG Godzilla and, you know, the more modern one in the MonsterVerse. It's a really cool like mix of the two. I really, like really dig it.
My house is huge Godzilla and Kong fans, because my middle son, who just turned 13 on Thursday, he is like huge Godzilla, like the black and white anime Godzilla with the subtitles all the way back to those ones. And
that's what's up.
He loves the black and white ones. Those are his favorite.
Well, we got the posters. So I'm hearing there's a con somewhere this weekend, so we're probably going to get the trailer for it. But what I was going to say really quick is I think this one's going to take place in Middle Earth. which I'm excited about because there's going to be a lot of fighting. You know, they don't have to worry about, you know, going into buildings and killing people. I think the fight's going to be in Middle Earth.
From Variety, Thanksgiving sequel in the works with director Eli Roth.
Yeah, when I saw that that TikTok video or whatever it was, that reel that he put out, I was so excited because I was so stoked with this movie, and I knew it was going to get a sequel. I'm just really glad that he's telling us like so soon, and it's going to be probably a couple of years. Like, you know, he said like around Thanksgiving ish 25. Before we actually get it, and that's fine, but man, I want more John Carver. I can't wait.
Yeah, he was saying he's going to take a year to get it right, which is awesome. He's not going to just rush into something, and hopefully it's out around Thanksgiving 2025. I haven't seen it yet, but I've heard nothing but positive stuff on it. So,
I mean, just from the trailer that we showed on the horror show, it was really awesome, especially when her face got stuck to the inside of the freezer and she pulls it away and it's just sticking right there.
Yeah. Some really creative kills. I feel like with this one, he did shy away a little bit, especially when you compare it to the original trailer where it came from, the Grindhouse trailer. He kind of shied away a little bit with some of the descriptive kills, but I feel like that's probably just studio interference. I hope they give him
more free reign,
to do what he does best, you know.
Okay, time for our blast from the past. Okay, this week I'm doing it. It is Baby Boom.
My mom loved this movie.
I was a fan of this movie. I watched it so many times.
This is another one that was always watched in my house.
Okay, Baby Boom is a 1987 American romantic comedy drama film directed by Charles Shire, written by Nancy Myers and Shire, and produced by Myers and Bruce A. Block for United Artists. It stars Diane Keaton It stars Diane Keaton as a yuppie who discovers that her long-lost cousin has died, leaving her a 14-month-old baby girl as an inheritance. Okay, guys, if you haven't seen this movie, it is really good. She starts a baby food company to support the baby because she was like a lawyer and about to make partner, and then the baby comes in and her husband leaves her and she's stuck with the baby by herself. And that's all the details I'm going to give you because I don't want to spoil it all. So go check out Baby Boom. It is a really good movie.
Yeah, I remember seeing, like I said, raised by all my sisters. So that was a movie that was always on back then too.
Okay. Now we are moving on to coming soon. On December 8th, we have Poor Things, The Boy and Heroine, Elaine, Fast Charlie, The End We Start From, Lord of Morales, and The Crypto. What are you guys looking forward to this week?
Thanksgiving.
I think I'm not going to any movie this weekend.
Poor Things actually looks really good. That's the new one with Emma Stone. Intriguing, actually. I'm actually looking forward to that one. And then The Boy and the Heron, that's the new Studio Ghibli anime that looks pretty good, too. But, might go check out Poor Things with the wife.
Let me know if that's good.
I sure will.
Okay, let's move on to our second trailer. This one was brought to us by Brandon.
Yeah.
Whatever you have to do.
Freaking cool.
Yeah, I saw this right away. I'm like, damn, I can't wait for this one, man.
Promise me you'll find your way home. Furiosa.
About this casting, I was mopping the living room. And when they said they were going to cast her, I was like, yes. I like her acting and Charlize Theron's character for Furiosa, man. I was like, you
know. Yeah.
I'm assuming before the movie comes out.
Blows my mind that Chris Hemsworth.
Lady and Jones!
That's him? That's crazy.
Yeah, with the nose prosthetic and like contact, he doesn't have like those baby blues, you know? It's crazy how much it does not look like him.
Of angels. The question is,
damn,
do you have it in you to make it epic?
Remember her.
Yeah, that's what I'm excited
I'm stoked that we're getting more out of this, you know, Road Warrior world, even if it doesn't have Mad Max in it. And George Miller has such an awesome visual look to his movies. I'm so stoked about this. I cannot wait.
Same. It looks like it's another awesome. One of those female empowering movies where the woman's the main, like, badass, and it looks like something I would really like.
You're all over that, yeah.
But it doesn't shove it down your throat. She just looks like a total badass, yeah. And I can't get over Chris Hemsworth in that with the nose prosthesis and the darker color eyes. The makeup is amazing in this. It does not look like him. But you can tell, like, once you know that it's him, then you
look
for some of his features and you're like, holy shit, that is him. That's so good.
And then the voice too. I saw the trailer the first time and I knew he was in the movie. Obviously it says his name, but I wasn't looking for him. I was just looking for Anna Taylor-Joy, and I'm like, damn. But once you know, like you said. That was crazy.
Yeah.
Okay, are we ready to feel old?
Let's do it.
We go.
Too late.
Our number ones in the world. Okay, so this one, when I was looking it up the other day, my son was in the room with me. And he goes, I'm not that old yet. Okay, my son's turning 17 here at the end of the month. This movie is now 10 years old.
Oh, shit. Yeah, it is.
Yeah. Never seen it still, but hey.
This movie is 20 years old. And for the second week in a row, this movie is 30 years old.
Uh-huh.
It's another one that was played a lot at my house.
Oh, yeah. I used to watch that
one. And here is your 40 years old movie.
Uh-oh.
Pretty hairy. I'm gonna go back.
Is at it again. Here's the 51 next.
I don't have the 50. I only went to 40.
What?
All right. I might have to do 50 next.
No, that's 40's enough.
Okay, what are we watching this week?
I started Reacher. Kevin had brought it up a couple times, and I think Harley did too.
I did.
And we're like, I heard it a couple times. So we were like, what do we watch? I'm like, I've been hearing about this show, and I'm like halfway through the first season. Holy shit, that's a good show.
It's so good. Yeah, I can't wait for season two.
Brandon, what are you watching this week?
We're going to see Silent Night tonight, that new John Woo movie.
That's what's up.
Last night we watched, we started watching some Christmas movies. This week we watched Spirited last night. That's the one that came out last year with Ryan Reynolds and Will Ferrell, the musical, like with the Scrooge story.
Yeah.
Such a good movie. We really liked that one. I got Apple TV just so that we could watch that one again, and then we'll watch
Monarch.
We've got that for the month, so we can watch Charlie Brown Christmas and stuff too. But I might now that I have Apple TV for the month, I might check out the MonsterVerse show. What's it called again? The
Monarch.
Yeah, Monarch. Yeah.
The Legacy Begins, maybe, or something like that. You made me question myself. Yeah, I would say to watch it. I like, for what it is, I liked it. And we stopped on the second episode, and I'm like, let's go to the next one. And the kids were like, we're done for the day. I'm like, so I had like that. I wanted to know what happens next. So yeah, I'm liking it.
There's a lot of good stuff on Apple TV.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I used up my free trial like a while ago, like last year or something, and binge watched the shit out of Ted Lasso. I still need to watch the last season of that one though. But
it ended so perfect, dude. That show ended so, yeah. I started watching it because of you, actually. You brought it up a couple times when we were talking, and I started it, and I just sat there and went through all the seasons.
You should watch C on Apple TV.
What?
C.
C. Yeah. S-E-E. C.
Yes.
Isn't that where like everyone's blind? Everyone in the world
except
is blind.
For a few people. Yeah. Like,
yeah.
It's got Jason Momoa in it. It's really good.
Mm-hmm.
Like the action in it, it surprises you.
Yeah.
So this week I was watching Family Switch. Genie and Eight Crazy Nights. Genie.
Yeah, we watched Genie. That was actually a lot better than I expected it to be.
What's that one?
It's a new one with Melissa McCarthy, Christmas movie where she plays the.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I've seen the trailer somewhere.
Kind of a like a Hallmark movie feel to it a little bit, but funnier.
You should watch Family Switch.
You were explaining that.
Is that the one with Ed Helms from Andy from The Office? Yeah.
It's hilarious. Is like it? The mom and the daughter switch bodies.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like Freaky Friday, but the mom and the daughter switch, the dad and the son switch, and the baby and the dog.
That's funny. Yeah, it sounds like something
so you've got this,
like watch.
You got this baby crawling around on all fours, and then you know how when dogs go to scratch their butt on the floor? So it shows the baby doing the whole rubbing its butt across the floor.
Oh, that's funny.
And then you got this dog walking on two legs, and the person watching the baby's like, huh? Trying to figure out. He's like, this is why you're confused.
Right, check it out.
Okay. Well, that is it for this episode of Mod Squad Movie Talk Monday. Guys, go check out our community. This is where all the fun happens. It's just all right there. And also, go check out Back to the Retro Review, The Daily Dank, the last podcast you want, and all of our other shows you're watching. The Movie Show, go check out The Horror Show and The Gaming Show. And we go live every Saturday night with a giveaway. For Felix, Brandon, myself, and the entire Mod Squad, see you next time, Puddin'.
See ya.